A lot of stuff has gone on since I last talked to you guys with Around the Hobby, and I'm apologizing for it, but you know what? Instead of me getting into all of that and apologizing right off, let's just get into this episode because we've got to talk about what went on at National. We've got to talk about the Topps cards. We've got to talk about Panini's website crashing and a whole lot of other stuff. So let's just roll the intro and get right into this episode. What is going on, everybody? Welcome to another episode of Around the Hobby. And, you know, first of all, before I even get into this episode, I got to apologize to everybody for a few things that's going on in this episode. First of all, I'm using a new camera. I'm not using the new one now, but I did some pre-recorded stuff with the new camera. I'm also using a completely new audio setup. So I'm hoping the audio is much cleaner and clearer using this new digital setup that I've got. But I want to apologize up front with using the new camera. A couple times when you see those segments, you might see the image jump a little bit, and I apologize for it. Also, you notice that I'm at a different angle. Well, what happened is I sort of ran out of ink when I was printing the script, so you're going to see me look this way every so often because I have my script right here on my computer. Now that all of that's taken care of, I want to welcome everybody to a full regular episode of Around the Hobby. For a lot of the new people out there that don't know what I do, well, I'm just going to kind of go over a lot of the news and notes and everything that goes on in this collecting hobby. And I'm really pushing more towards basketball. I've noticed a lot more interest in basketball, so I'm going to include a lot more basketball stuff in as I go forward. But now, you know, we got to get into all the nooks and crannies and all the good stuff that goes on. And the first thing I'm going to do is give some shout outs. Now, if you want a shout out, you can just ask me in the comments, or, you know, you can just comment down below. That's where I pull the shout outs from. Now, I'm trying to give shout outs to just different channels in general. There's no rhyme or reason as to who I pick. But this time there is. I normally do 3 shout outs, but this time we're going to 4. And, you know, some of these are very new YouTubers with under 50 subs, and one of these is an absolute legend in the YouTube card collecting community. So first one I want to give a shout out to is Reindeer Studios. Reindeer Studios commented, "Those black borders are sweet. Time to buy some new one touches." And for those of you that don't know, in the kind of down and dirty episode, he's talking about these. Yes, I have not opened mine up yet. These are the new Ultra Pro Black One Touches, and they're making a run at Pro Mold. You can see the back of it right there, but I'm just glad that they're finally clearing up because, you know, I've used Pro Mold for a long time, and Pro Mold is mostly because of their clarity, and I think that they've made a big step forward in their clarity in comparison to the Pro Mold. But if you want these black borders, and a lot of people are starting to use them and they're loving them, you've got to get them from Amazon. I do not know right yet if they're available on their website, but it is available through their Amazon store. So thank you, Reindeer Studios, for that comment. Next is from Four Leaf Cards. He comments, "Thanks for the update, Snoop. Four Leaf, I'm glad to do these updates. I try to get these out as much as possible, but life happens, and sometimes I just can't, which is why you guys have had to wait a while for a full episode. But, you know, I'm kind of going to continue with these little mini episodes. I kind of like doing them. They're fast, they're quick, and doesn't take a lot of time because I've got a lot of videos that need to come out. Next is from Grandpa Joe's Closet. I love that name. Grandpa commented, "Love your new style format." Well, thank you, Grandpa Joe. You know, I kind of like doing this style format, and with the camera angles, one of the challenges is, if you notice over my shoulder right there, I try to keep it blank so that I can put up little stuff and all of that. But anyway, glad you enjoyed it. Glad you like this style format. I'm going to try to continue it on. Things are getting ready to slow down after Labor Day at work. Next is a comment from a YouTube legend. This guy is legendary in the YouTube community. He is known as Sevens, but his channel is AR Falk 77. Very informative video. Thanks for sharing. Good luck on setting up that office. First of all, Sevens, I can't believe you actually watched the mess of videos that I created, but thank you for watching. And the office is coming along pretty well. I've got some stuff hung up and just got in a case, and it's just a lot of work going on in here, plus working and trying to get videos up. But thank you, Sevens, for watching. I just can't believe a YouTube legend is actually watching my videos. Anyway, everybody, I'm not going to tell you to sub, but I will tell you, go check these channels out. Reindeer Studios, Four Leaf Cards, Grandpa Joe's Closet, and AR Falk 77. Check these channels out. Check out their videos. You might like them. You might just hit that little subscribe button. All right. Well, the big thing we got to talk about is the National Sports Card Convention and a lot of the stuff that went on there. Now, at the National Sports Card Convention, this year's convention drew the biggest crowd since 1991, according to the convention organizers. While promoters of the show don't give specific attendance number figures, they say the number of attendees this year in Chicago are larger than what they had seen in Anaheim, California 28 years ago. Over 64,000 tickets were sold at that event in California, which occurred at the height of the sports card boom. In all, over 90,000 attendees attended at the Anaheim, California show, and there were more this year in Chicago. While the 40th National Sports Collectors Convention overall attendance exceeded our expectations, one of the highest in history, it was a significant increase in Wednesday and Thursday turnouts that was the most impressive, says Ray Shuttle, director of NSCC Communications. The National also has announced the dates for the 2020 convention in New Jersey. It will take place July 29th through August 2nd at the Atlantic City Convention Center, which last hosted this convention in 2016. The convention will then return to Chicago in 2021 and then to Cleveland in 2022. So, you know, something to look forward to right after New Year. We start making plans and finding out little things going on with that. Now, while we're on the topic of the national convention, let me get into some of the other things that had happened. Now, no arrests were made at the convention, but law enforcement was there and they were present. Rumor about someone kind of making a stash and grab, it turns out that it was just that and just a rumor. There were no confirmed arrests made by Rosemont Police or Chicago Police Department. However, the FBI was there and they were there with a lot of agents and they were handing out grand jury subpoenas. Approximately 29 to 32 subpoenas were given out during the week of the National. Several hobby businesses received subpoenas seeking sales lists, customer records, and other material. The effort is tied to an industry probe of transactions, including those involving the altered card scandal, better known as Slabgate. PWCC and at least two authentication companies are known to have turned over numerous cards to federal investigators that are suspected of being doctored. Collectors who own any of these cards highlighted in the forum threads from Blowout are being offered refunds through PWCC, which is forwarding the returned cards to the FBI and is cooperating with the FBI in all their investigations. Agents have also been gathering information from those authentication and grading companies over the past several weeks. Now, PSA has stated that it is conducting its own investigation and will not divulge any information or its findings publicly. So those of you that were hoping for a lot of transparency from PSA, it's not going to happen in the least bit. My thing with all of this is I do think there should be a little bit more transparency in the hobby overall. But we also have to look at this from the grand scheme of things. Now, I did ask that people want me to do a video on the whole Slabgate from beginning to end, and overwhelmingly, it was a yes. So I will do my best to try to get that up and try to get some time to do it. I'm not promising this is going to be done in a week, 2 weeks. It may take a month, but I will try to get it done. But overall, in the grand scheme of things, the number of cards that have been reported, I think the number's around 335 cards currently. Well, you have to look at that's over the course of several years. And PSA on average grades 660,000 cards a year. So in the grand scheme of things, it's a very minute number of cards. So from that, I'm going to say up front that most cards that we buy, we don't have anything to worry about. I think that's just something profound and pronounced. That doesn't even include SGC, which has a few in there, and Beckett that has quite a few cards in there. But at least everybody's working with the FBI so we can get these cards out. What I am hoping is that these cards are not destroyed by the FBI. I hope they just get reholdered as altered and then resold again. Now, since we're on the topic about PSA and Collector's Universe, Collector's Universe, the parent company of PSA and PSA DNA, just reported record revenues for fiscal year 2019 on Wednesday. The company took in $72.5 million in fiscal 2019, which ended on June 30th. That figure includes a record $5.4 million, or an increase of 25% in trading card and autograph authentication revenues. Revenue from the trading card and autograph submissions in the fourth quarter also grew to record highs, thanks to a growing number of submissions. In all, PSA and PSA DNA processed over 680,000 items in the last 3 month stretch. That's up from 620,000 in the third fiscal quarter. Quote, the PSA and PSA DNA business set another all-time quarterly record revenue for the division that eclipsed last year's fourth quarter revenue by roughly $1.7 million, said Collectors Universe President Joe Orlando. PSA says it has now experienced 9 consecutive years of top and bottom line growth, and that record output of nearly 2.5 million items processed for the fiscal year has made it difficult for the company to handle an ongoing backlog of orders. Yes, they processed 2.5 million items for the fiscal year. And yes, they are having backlogs because of this influx. They're still dealing with the largest submission backlog in the company's history, Orlando said, and they continue to step up efforts to increase capacity so customer turnaround times can be reduced down a whole lot. Joe Orlando said, this is a clear indication of the power of the PSA brand and continues to the demand for our services. The company continues to work on expanding operational capacity so we can ultimately improve the extended turnaround times facing our customers. Now, at the end of the earnings report conference call, the company fielded questions, including a lot of questions that were related to the FBI investigation. Orlando said, quote, we don't view this as being a loophole on our end, and we think that in the overall scheme of our business that has come at this point has been blown way out of proportion. But we are very confident in the services that we provide and are very confident in the grading staff that we have, and so is the public. This is the exact battle that we deal with every day. I guess the way I would characterize this is none of this is really new news. It is not news to us. It is not news to the industry that these types of things go on. So there is really nothing out of the ordinary from that perspective about the investigation versus any other year in our history. That's the statement from Collectors Universe President Joe Orlando. So, yes, they do deal with these battles, but I do think PSA, especially with record growth and record submissions, should be a little bit more open about what's really going on. Anyway, you guys comment, because you're the ones that are submitting to PSA, if you think that they should be a little bit more transparent. What do you think about all the revenue growth that they're seeing? Comment down below. Let me know. Well, for you basketball fans out there, one of the most talked about rookies, Zion Williams, has just struck a deal with Panini. Panini America and agents for Zion Williamson have agreed to an exclusive trading card deal that will include autographs and products through 2019-2020 season. The first overall pick in the 2019 NBA draft by New Orleans Pelicans, Williamson's NBA arrival has been one of the most anticipated in years. His first officially licensed autographed cards will appear in 2019 Contenders Draft Picks Basketball, releasing early September, when he's still pictured in his Duke uniform. The first card that's going to picture him in an NBA uniform and his first autographs as an NBA player will release in October 2019. It's going to be 2019-2020 NBA Hoops Basketball. He'll also have cards and autographs and 25 additional Panini NBA products that are going to be released later on this season. So as a if you're a basketball collector and you're looking for some Zion autographs, just hold on. I'll try to do an update with new products and let you know when those products will be coming out. Now, 2019 Topps Chrome. If you are opening 2019 Topps Chrome, you probably already know the four main cards in this set are cut short. Vlad Jr., Pete Alonso, Tatis, and Jimenez are all cut short, including a lot of their parallels, serial number cards, and insert cards. The cards in question are cut approximately 2 millimeters shorter than other cards. Topps said that they have notified the third-party graders and that all of this stems from the cards being cut from a different machine. Topps says they do have the situation corrected and that later release boxes of this product will not have this issue. Now, the YouTube legend Mike O has verified with PSA that they will be grading these cards, and I'm assuming that means assigning a number to them. But this kind of opens a question up for me, and I'm pretty sure several of you also have this same question. With the whole Slabgate thing going on, this does open a door up for card trimmers, especially since Topps has admitted that these cards are cut 2 millimeters short. So if you get a later product and you held on to it and you notice, hey, it's a little off center top to bottom, let me just whack off about a millimeter or so, does that mean that card's going to get graded and will that create a problem for everybody in the hobby? We will find out shortly, I guess. I don't know. Maybe you guys can tell me somebody to try to contact, try to figure this one out. Okay? All right. You know, sports memorabilia is big business here in America. It's generating an estimated $1 billion in annual sales. And some of the rarest pieces sell for really large jaw-dropping prices. Mark McGwire's 70th home run ball snapped up $3 million in 1999. Mickey Mantle signed bat from his 56th season, $430,000 in 2014. Well, retired firefighter Charles Kerr from New Jersey was an avid autographed memorabilia collector, and he was so proud of his collection and so confident in its value, he would tell his lifelong partner's daughter, Jennifer Sullivan, she didn't have to worry about coming up with the money to pay for her two young children's college education. "I've got it all taken care of," Kerr would say. But not long after, he suddenly died last September, and Sullivan, she learned that Kerr had been bamboozled with his entire collection. The collection that Kerr had spent more than $100,000 building up, from autographed balls, bats, items signed by Babe Ruth, Mickey Mantle, and the other greats in baseball, were declared as not genuine. They were all sold by the same dealer, Ralph Perullo. That's when Sullivan decided to contact NBC News, and they spoke with Perullo and his former associates and with the FBI.
Retired firefighter Chuck Kerr's passion was owning a piece of history, an investment for his family.
He'd be like, "Don't worry, the kids have college taken care of. I got it all taken care of."
Chuck helped raise Jennifer Sullivan, whose mother was his longtime partner. When he died suddenly last fall, he left behind a huge collection.
This was his retirement plan. This was his 401k.
Yogi Berra autographed career stats ball.
Over $100,000 of memorabilia purchased from Ralph Perullo, best known for buying up Joe DiMaggio's personal collection from his estate back in 1999. The month after Chuck's funeral, one of Perullo's salesmen called to collect what he said was an overdue bill.
I said, "Listen, let me call my husband. Let me get back to you."
Brian was suspicious and brought some of the signed baseballs to an authenticator.
All four items came back as not authentic.
And they were all fakes.
Yeah.
So now what are you thinking?
I'm angry.
The Sullivans asked Chuck's credit card company for a partial refund and received about $7,000. That's when they say the intimidation started, including this voicemail from Perullo's salesman.
Yeah, Jennifer Gaving, Virgil DiMaggio State, calling, trying to see what this little stunt you're trying to pull. It ain't gonna work.
Then an email, apparently from Ralph Perullo himself, demanding they return some items and threatening legal action, writing, I am not going to go away.
You know, he's trying to intimidate her.
The Sullivans reached out to NBC News through a relative who works here. We paid a top authenticator, James Spence, to examine 11 more items.
This particular ball is what we'd call amateur hour.
All 11 rejected, declared not authentic. Then we bought three baseballs ourselves from Perullo's company.
Something like this would never be accepted in a Major League Baseball.
He looked at a Willie Mays signature under infrared light.
See how straight and direct that line is going up there? This one here wobbles.
If I'm hearing you correctly, this thing's a fake.
Yes, I would not put any value in this in terms of its authenticity.
Or in the other two either. A separate authenticator came to the same conclusion. All of these items from Perullo's company, all with letters of authenticity. We showed Perullo some of the balls we bought without saying where we got them.
We have a Willie Mays, and then I got a Mickey Mantle here.
I don't believe this one's real.
You don't think this one's real?
Right. Willie wouldn't sign this ball.
Why wouldn't he sign that ball?
It's not a Major League Baseball.
Perullo echoing what the authenticator told us.
So, Mr. Perullo, the ball in your right hand, we bought from you.
Pardon?
We bought the ball in your right hand from you.
Really?
How did a ball like that?
That's a good question.
Sold?
You got me.
For just the average person, they think,
yep,
that's it. I've got a Willie Mays ball.
I 100% agree.
We told him about Chuck Kerr, the retired firefighter.
He had basically used his entire life savings to buy memorabilia. All of those items came back as potentially fraud.
First I'm hearing of it.
We played his salesman's threatening voicemail.
How do you tell you won't escalate this, but now you forced your hand?
It seems like a lot of this has caught you by surprise. And
absolutely.
And I guess your salesman, David Ingber, called her boss at his office.
He's not going to be my salesman much longer.
We also showed him the email from his account to Jen Sullivan.
I'm not going to go away.
It's menacing.
This is
it has a menacing tone.
It's embarrassing. I would never write a letter like that. Never.
Let me ask you this. If you were the Sullivans, what would you think was going on there?
That's a good question. I intend to get to the bottom of it.
The Sullivans think Chuck Kerr was intentionally duped.
These people are knowingly selling fraudulent items. I don't care what anybody says. This is what they're doing.
So everybody, let me tell you, I cannot stress this enough. If you're going to collect autographs, I have certain players I will buy by just looking, you know, myself and comparing the autographs. But I am not a professional autograph grader. Do yourself a favor. If it's a big name player, Jackie, Mantle, Ruth, Ted Williams, Roy Campanella, if it's any of those guys, you've got to get certified autographs. Yes, there is always the needle in the haystack, but we're talking about your money. So do you really want to take a chance and not get a certified autograph? And I highly recommend you use the big four. That's SGC, which no longer does autograph grading, but they did. So there's a lot of things out there with the SGC autograph authentication. PSA, one of the big dogs. BGS, another big one, and JSA. If it's not from one of those four, or if they will not refund your money if it doesn't pass from PSA, BGS, or JSA, you do not want to buy it. Can't stress that enough. I don't know what's going to happen. If I hear any more about what's going to happen with the Sullivans, I'll let you guys know. Panini America's website crashed all over one card. Panini America offered boxes of 2018-2019 Contenders Draft Picks basketball through its First Off the Line program Thursday morning, and the result was a frustrating experience for collectors and people that tried to buy this product. of the hottest NBA prospect in years. Yes, the possibility of Zion Williamson cards made contenders the big draw, with Panini limiting orders to one box per customer. Blowout Cards has announced that they were willing to pay $300 per box. That's $170 above retail for anyone that could land a box and send it to them. So it's automatically created an instant profitable buy and flip opportunity for those looking to do that. While other people are buying the product and hoping that they're going to pull a Zion autograph card for themselves. Minutes before the product was scheduled to go live at 10 a.m. Central Time, Panini's website began to experience problems because of such heavy traffic, stalling for some, and then by 10 a.m., it completely crashed out. Others were able to access the page where contender boxes were offered, and when they clicked the Add to Cart, they saw the product was removed once they tried to enter the payment portal. Panini America's website, eventually, they just took the whole site offline. Later, the company has issued a posted message about this product and this problem. Quote, overwhelming demand for this product caused our service to crash, and we are temporarily postponing the release of contenders, draft picks, college basketball. We apologize for the inconvenience. We will relist this product as soon as it will be available to everyone with a 24-hour notice prior to launch. End quote. Now, it's not known how many boxes of Panini contenders draft picks first off the line were scheduled that actually made it out to everybody through this platform. But there are boxes available on eBay. So if you are trying to pull that Zion autograph, might want to go to eBay and get it. Well, Topps is going mobile. Yeah, you heard me right. I guess now there is Topps Mobile. Topps unveiled the card-covered vehicle that looks like a food truck that's just covered from top to bottom and front to back with baseball cards. It made its debut in Brooklyn just ahead of the National Baseball Card Day, and Spectrum News New York did a story about National Baseball Card Day, and it has a lots of video footage of this truck.
In Brooklyn, some collectors of baseball cards got a special treat yesterday. Check out this truck. It's covered in thousands of baseball cards. It rolled into downtown Brooklyn as part of National Baseball Card Day, which is today. Trading card company Topps handed out free baseball cards and also hosted giveaways and trivia contests all about America's favorite pastime.
There's a lot of people who collected when they were kids. You know, as they got older, maybe they didn't collect as much, but now that they're parents themselves, they find that it's something to do fun again with their kids.
And some lucky fans could find an autographed card inside their pack. To find out where you can get your free pack of cards, just go to tops.com/National Baseball Card Day. It's nice to have an activity you can share with your kids and do some collecting, right?
It is. That truck is something.
Now, most people like seeing stories about super collectors, and I'm one of those that love seeing these kinds of stories. Well, super collector Tim Sharrow from Lighton, PA, is just that. He's a super collector. Walk into Tim's memorabilia room, and it does not take long to figure out which player he collects. Tim is one of the country's top Pete Rose fans and collectors, with over 5,000 items, and he's still adding to his collection. The local ABC affiliate, WNEP 16, stopped by for a tour of Tim's collection and to find out why he's remained such a big fan of Pete Rose.
A man from Carbon County has a basement that looks similar to what you'd see at the National Baseball Hall of Fame.
But this collection of thousands of items is dedicated to one of the best players in baseball history who is not enshrined in Cooperstown. Any guesses as to who? NewsWatch 16's Chase Sr. has the answer.
If you're a fan of America's pastime and you were teleported here, you might think you ended up in some baseball museum.
Started collecting Pete Rose memorabilia in the early 80s when he was playing for the Philadelphia Phillies. They won the World Series in 1980, and at that time, nobody brought the intensity to the game of baseball like Pete Rose did.
But this is actually the basement of Tim Sharrow's home near Lehighton, a basement with more than 5,000 items of Pete Rose memorabilia on display.
He just never gave up at any time. And any play that was that he was involved with, he was given 110% in every play that, you know, that he could.
And Sharrow's admiration for the all-time hit king, also known as Charlie Hustle, was recently featured in the sports.
A man from Carbon County has a basement that looks similar to what you'd see at the National Baseball Hall of Fame.
But this collection of thousands of items is dedicated to one of the best players in baseball history who is not enshrined in Cooperstown. Any guesses as to who? NewsWatch 16's Chase Sr. has the answer.
If you're a fan of America's pastime and you were teleported here, you might think you ended up in some baseball museum.
Started collecting Pete Rose memorabilia in the early 80s when he was playing for the Philadelphia Phillies. They won the World Series in 1980, and at that time, nobody brought the intensity to the game of baseball like Pete Rose did.
But this is actually the basement of Tim Shara's home near Lee Heighton, a basement with more than 5,000 items of Pete Rose memorabilia on display.
He just never gave up at any time. And any play that was that he was involved with, he was given 110% in every play that, you know, that he could.
And Shero's admiration for the all-time hit king, also known as Charlie Hustle, was recently featured in the Sports Illustrated for Kids article by SI Kids reporter Anna Lively. She's also from the Lee Heighton area. In this impressive man cave, you can find everything from bats and balls signed by Rose to autographed pictures, magazine covers, cigarette packaging, and even Pete Rose's high school yearbook. Chances are, if Pete Rose was on it, Shero, a teacher in the Lee Heighton area school district, has it.
Every time I come down here, I just always see something new, and it's just really cool to see all the Pete Rose stuff.
The biggest thing that I found with my collecting is that the friendship I'm making with other people that share the same passion that I have, now we can kind of talk to each other about it, and then we help each other out, find different things that maybe I don't have or one of my friends might not have, and then we try to hook each other up with getting different items.
And despite Pete Rose having the most hits in Major League Baseball history, he is not in the Hall of Fame. He was kicked out of baseball for betting on the game. Here's Shero's thoughts on that controversial topic.
Pete was the greatest hitter of all time. He played the game of baseball with so much intensity that it very seldom is matched by any player. Worst case scenario, they put an asterisk or something by his name, but there's no doubt in my mind that Pete belongs in the Hall of Fame.
And many fans may agree. Shero adds his wife demands that the Pete Rose collection doesn't extend above the basement. Chase Senior, NewsWatch 16, Carbon County.
Good tidbit.
Now, for a lot of you player collectors and set builders out there, there's one book you have to have. That's the Beckett Almanac. Beckett's new baseball card almanac is just hitting the market. The 24th edition of this book includes prices and checklists for nearly 2 million cards and collectible items across different eras, including regional and oddball sets from the past. The book is over 1,300 pages and weighs over 4 pounds. The cover price, $49.95. But you can order one on eBay directly from Beckett for $37.50. All right, now that's basically everything that's been going on around the hobby over these past couple of weeks. So now, as usual, it's time to get into some new releases. Now, let me say up front, I'm going to back this up to Wednesday, the 28th, because that's originally when I had planned for this video to come out. And I hadn't talked about stuff that's coming out on the 28th anyway. And it's really not a lot over these next 2 weeks. It's only 5 items. There's some big ticket items, but it's only 5 items that are coming out. So let's go ahead and get into some new releases coming out over these next 2 weeks. August 28th, 2019 Panini Absolute Football. 2019 Absolute Football, each box will deliver 3 autographs and 1 rookie premier material autograph and 2 memorabilia cards. There's a Kaboom insert, 1 premier material autograph inside of every box. Begin collecting NFL's newest rookies who look to make a name for themselves. Find loads of unique memorabilia, max number to $399 with multiple parallels. In addition to autographs in every box, there are tools of the trade, which feature many swatch materials from current NFL stars. Find jerseys, gloves, footballs, pants, socks, shoes, helmets, and jackets. Parallels are doubled, number to 99 or less, triple, 75 or less, quad, 60 or less, 5, 60 or less, double prime, 49 or less, triple prime, 49 or less, quad prime, 49 or less, 5 prime, double autos, triple autos, double autos prime, triple autos prime, double autos platinum edition, and triple auto platinum edition. Also look for Boss Hog autographs, iconic inks, jumbo shields, head-to-toe memorabilia cards, and an insert card in every box. Parallels include gold serial numbered to 10 and green serial numbered R1-of-1s. The average price per box is $150. Also released on August 28th is 2019 Topps 5-Star Baseball. Topps 5-Star Baseball delivers two autographs signed on card unless replaced by a cut signature or autograph patch card in every box. Topps 5-Star Baseball is back with high-end design and a premium checklist that guarantees 100% on-card autographs of the game's best major league players. This year, look for more rare case-level hits and new production additions such as Prometheus Penmanship autographs and 5-Tool Phenom autographs, all signed on-card. There are case hits of silver signatures to 30, most collectible MLB players of past and present with autographs in silver ink, one in every case. Also, golden graphs, which feature autographs in gold ink and one in every case. There are purple parallels for these also numbered to 25, blues to 20, greens to 15, golds to 10, orange to 5, and reds are 1-of-1s. Five-star signatures include inscriptions and are numbered to 20 or less. Five-star autograph jumbo patch cards feature the hottest veterans and rookies and retired players, and the jumbo patch pieces are numbered to 25 or less. Parallels are gold, silver rainbow, team patch, 1-of-1s, and MLB batter silhouette logo patch, 1-of-1, laundry tags, and majestic patches. Five-star cut signature cards. Each cut signature is a rare 1-of-1. Also, five-star celebrity cut signatures, where each is a 1-of-1. August 30th, 2019 Leaf Trinity Football is being released, and Trinity Football box will contain five autograph cards. Look for Trinity Patch autographs, where you can find the top 2019 football draft picks, including large swatches from player-worn jerseys. Trinity Signature autographs feature the top draft prospects, and clear autographs feature a stunning acetate design. Look for multiple tier of parallels through this numbered set, as low as 1-of-1. Also find autographs from players like Kyler Murray, Daniel Jones, DK Metcalf, Dwayne Haskins, Drew Lock, Nick Bosa, Josh Jacobs, Benny Snell Jr., and many, many more. September 4th, 2019 Draft Contenders Picks Collegiate Basketball is being released. 2019 Panini Contenders Draft Picks Collegiate Basketball card delivers six autographs, one parallel, 25 base season tickets, 35 season ticket variations, and 30 inserts in every box. Look for the 2019 NBA rookie class in their college uniforms and look for on-card autographs in this product. Look for RPS college tickets, which feature on-card autographs from all of the upper-tier rookies in the 2019 NBA draft, as well as three separate variations and parallels. Parallels include college draft tickets to 99, college playoff tickets to 15, college championship tickets are 1-of-1s, cracked ice to 23, cayenne, magenta, yellow, and black printing plates are all 1-of-1. International tickets, where you can find autographs from top foreign-born NBA draft picks. Legacy signatures feature autographs from former standouts and NBA stars. Season ticket signatures, and this 10-card set features autographs from some of the greatest players to ever step foot on a college campus. Turning pro signatures, game day ticket signatures. The set is a 50-card base set featuring current and retired NBA superstars. September 4th, 2019, Topps Luminaries Baseball will be released, and Luminaries Baseball is one autograph or relic card in every box featuring the very best that the Diamond has to offer from past, present, and future. Every card is encased and numbered to 15 or less. Topps Luminaries Baseball products will include Home Run Kings, which are paralleled red numbered to 10, blue to 5, and blacks are 1-of-1s. Hit Kings, Masters of the Mound, Home Run King Ultra Books, the top home run hitters in the game, which are numbered to 1-of-1. Home Run King Ultimate Book will have 50 autographs on one card, and they are 1-of-1s. Hit King Ultra Book feature 10 autographs, 1-of-1s. Hit King Ultimate Book will feature 40 autographs on one card. Masters of the Mound Great Looks card will feature 30 autos on one card. And the new Lighting the Way dual autograph card featuring two players from different eras with similar playing styles are numbered to 5 or less. Also in Luminaries, look for Home Run Kings, Hit Kings, regular Masters of the Mound, Hit King Patches, Masters of the Mound dual booklet card, Letters book card, new Lighting the Way dual autograph relics, cut signature relics, also cut signature bat knob book cards, and additional cards along the way. You get one card per box. Well, guys, that's it. That's it for this episode. This is one of the absolute longest episodes I've ever done for Around the Hobby. And quite frankly, I'm pretty tired of editing and doing all this recording and messing with the cameras and all of that stuff. But anyway, normally when I leave you guys, I'm always hitting up with something with baseball. But Chris from CT Productions has done something with football. And I think, you know, well, with preseason going on and a lot of people getting riled up for the football season, maybe it's better I kind of let you guys go with something from football. So with that being said, I want to tell everybody, I hope you have a blessed time. Thank you for watching all the way through this thing. And remember to collect what you love, but love what you collect. So with that being said, Chris, CT Productions, take us out of here with some football. I'll see you guys next time.
I've done it before, I've seen it before. Tears splashing the floor when I open the door for her. She acting like a whore and I'm a letter. Learn from Project Catcher. Pippin' got a master. You do what you want, you do what you need. Just don't let this get back to me. You do what you want, you do what you please. Do whatever will help you sleep. Said that she's gonna be okay. She calls as if there was nothing wrong. Okay, okay, okay. So back to what I was saying. This could be us, but you're playing. This could be us, but you're playing. I'm bouncing out crazy. Fuck what the niggas were saying. This could be us, but you're playing. This could be us, but you're playing. Tracy McGrady. Before that girl touch anything, she gotta say please.
Say please.
And I know they really wish we would all to be fucking on the big bad wolf. As a full moon, y'all talk money in the sneaker. Watch how your dreams hit the floor. I do what I want, I do what I need, do whatever will help me sleep. She called me up in the early morning, she asked if we're gonna be okay.
So back to where I was saying, this could be us, but you're playing. This could be us, but you're playing. I'm hard, I don't sound crazy. Fuck what the niggas were saying. This could be us, but she playing. This could be us, but she playing. But she, that's all I was saying. Spin the bottle. Spin the fucking bottle. If you the reason why it's empty, baby, spin the bottle. Truth or dare, nah, you don't know about it. Spin the bottle, spin the fucking bottle. If you the reason why it's empty, spin the fucking bottle. This could be us, but you're playing. This could be us, but you're playing.